G'day everyone, welcome to another episode of Python using Spike Prime. Today we're going to learn how to use the math functions to improve your code. Hello, my name is Gary and I'm glad you have stuck around because I was very scared that everybody would run away when they heard the word math. But today I'm going to promise you that we're going to do something cool with a robot to improve our code by learning a little bit about how to use maths in Python and how it's going to make your life as a coder a lot easier, and hopefully it's going to help you with your homework as well. So let's get right to it. So in Scratch, I want you to open up a new project. So here we start a new project, call it CA Python Maths. Make sure we click on the Python button, click Create. Here we go. All right, let's start off with something simple. So here, after where we create the objects, let's go x equals 5 and y equals 6. Okay. Now, what I'm going to teach you now is to use the print function. So the print function goes like this. You go print, open bracket, x plus y. Okay. And what this is going to do is that this print function is what Python programmers use to debug their code or to read different readings from their code. And you don't even have to type it onto the front of your robot. You can just read it from the screen. So it's going to make it really, really efficient for you to capture this information. So let's have a look at this. So we go print x plus five, x plus y, and then let's connect our robot. So as you can see, once you click the play button, it's going to print x plus y in the console. So you have to press this little tab to see the readouts coming out of that console. Okay, so this is how we do addition. And to do subtraction, it's just x minus y. Multiplication is x and then star y. So the star key is shift 8. And division is x and then forward slash y. So if we press play now, in the console, it's going to read out 4 extra lines. One which is x plus y, then x minus y, multiplication, so x times y, and then x divided by y. Okay, so here are the 4 extra lines. And in Python, there is an extra math operator that we use a lot, and that is modulus. So modulus is represented by the percent symbol. So when you go x modulus y or x percentage sign y, then what it does is it divides the first number by the second number, and then it returns the remainder. Okay, so what's left over. So right now we have x and y as 5 and 6. So if I go 5 modulus 6 or 5 percentage sign 6, then it's going to divide 5 by 6. So 6 goes into 5 how many times? It doesn't go in any time, so it goes in 0 times. But what's left over at the end? 5 is left over. So the answer to 5 modulus 6 is 5. Okay, so let's see that in action. So we go print x modulus y modulus. So this is first number divided by second number, return the remainder. Okay, so if I press play now, that final line is 5 because 6 goes into 5 zero times and then there's 5 as a remainder. Okay. What if I made x equal to 15? Then 15 divided by 6, so 6 goes into 15 twice, and then 3 is a remainder, so the answer will be 3. So if I press play again, see? The answer is 3. So why would we use the modulus function? Well, the modulus function is really useful for if we wanted to find if something is divisible by something else. So if I had a really big number and I wanted to see if one number was divisible by something, then all I have to do is check if the modulus of the number is equal to zero. So let's try that. So here, let's have a bit of a math exercise. Check if 264 is divisible by 7. Okay, so we go, all we have to do is we go if 264 modulus 7 equal to 0, that means that 7 is going into 264 exactly neatly, so because there's no remainder, then we'll print two 64 is divisible by 7. Else, we print 264 is not divisible by 7. And then we'll say plus str 264 modulus 7 plus is remaining. So what we're saying is if it's divisible by 7, it will say that it's divisible by 7. If it's not divisible by 7, it will say it's not divisible by 7 and tell us how much is remaining. See? So it prints out 264 is not divisible by 7. 5 is remaining. Okay? Because I'm printing out also the modulus of 264 mod 7 and 5 is remaining. Okay? What about if it is divisible, so 280? Oh, whoops, I'll also have to type in 280 here as well. 280. 280. 280. Sorry, that was a mistake. Here we go. Now it says 280 is divisible by 7. Okay, so modulus is really helpful for a lot of exercises, so it's good to know how it works. What about some of the other math functions? So math in Python is very robust. There's a lot of cool bits of functionality. One of them is the floor and ceiling function. So if I go print math dot ceil 6.6. Then what it does is it rounds the number up to the nearest whole number. Okay? So if I print the ceiling of 6.6, it will be 7. So if I press play. Oh, whoops, what happened here? Math is not defined. Why not? Oh, because we haven't actually imported math. So here is probably where I'll say to just go import math. Okay, because math functions are really important for all sorts of programming. And sometimes in order to use these more advanced functions, you'll need to import math at the start. Okay, let's try it again. Here we go. Now math is using the ceiling function to round 6.6 up to the nearest whole number. Okay? The opposite of that is to do the floor. So math dot floor 6.6. What that does, it rounds down to the nearest whole number. Okay, so the first answer, the second last line that's going to be printed should be 7, and then the last line should be 6 because it's rounding up to the nearest whole number and then rounding down to the nearest whole number. See? 7 and 6. Okay. So what if I wanted to round a really big number to another very big number? So for example, if I wanted to do an exercise challenge using math.floor, round the number 268 down to the nearest 10. Okay? So we already know that math ceiling and math floor round up and down to the nearest whole number. But if I wanted to round, say, 268 to the nearest 10, then I'm going to need to be smart with the way I run this function. So here, all I have to do is go 268 divided by 10. Okay, so we're dividing it by 10 to turn it into 26.8. And then I can go math.floor 26.8. And what that will do is that we'll turn it into a decimal and then we floor it. So it rounds down to the nearest decimal. And then at the end, we multiply by 10 again. Okay? So if I print that, then it's going to round 268 down to the nearest 10. See? 260. Cool. So working with maths is really fun in Python, and I hope that I showed you a few new tools. And as promised, I'm going to show you how we can improve the code that we did before with our turning function. To make it so that it is a lot more robust. So in order to do that, let's load up our old turning code. This is from last lesson. So the problem with this code is that we had a right-hand turn and a custom right-hand turn, but it's a very weak function because we only use it for the right-hand turn. And if I wanted to do a left-hand turn, I'd have to write out a whole new function. Which is not very smart, isn't it? It's not very something, a bit of code that you'd be very proud of. So we are going to use some math functions to improve it and make it cooler. Okay? So in your old code, let's start define a new function. So we go define, and then I'm just going to call this the gyro turn because this is the code that I use myself, and this is going to be more of an all-round general. Accurate turning function. So what's this gyro turn? First thing is that we determine an angle, and then we also determine two things. We want to do the left motor speed and the right motor speed. Okay. So what I want to do with this function is that I want to state an angle, and I don't want to have to think about if it's a positive or a negative angle, because all I care about is that it's turning a certain angle towards the left or towards the right, right? So in Spike, turning to the right is a positive turn. So it goes from 0 to 10, 20, 30 degrees. But turning to the left, it goes negative 10, negative 20, negative 30 degrees, right? Wouldn't it be nice if we can change it so that it doesn't matter if it's a positive or negative number? That's where a mathematical idea called absolute value comes in. Absolute value turns a number into its absolute value, and it doesn't care if it's a positive or negative, it just turns it into a positive number. basically. So negative 5, the absolute value of negative 5 is 5. And the absolute value of 5 is also 5. So turning the absolute value of a number for our gyroturn is going to be really handy to unify the left and right turns. So show you what I mean here. So we go gyroturn, angle, left speed, right speed. So what am I doing here? So I go while, and then it's almost exactly the same here. So I can copy this code. While the motion sensor get your angle is less than the angle, right? But what if I was doing a left turn? Then it will always be less than the angle because it's going negative 10, 20, or 30, right? So this is where I use a math absolute value. So here I go up to the top, I go import math, and then here I go while math.fabs. And this will turn the whole hub sensor's angle to a positive number because it's getting the absolute value number of this yaw angle. Doesn't matter if it's negative or positive. While it is less than the angle that we specify, we move the wheels. But instead of moving the wheels straight or a certain turn, we use the left speed and the right speed. So wheels dot move, oh no, start tank, and then we go left speed and right speed, and then of course at the end we go wheels dot stop. Now let's test it. So instead of doing this custom turn, we're going to make it so that we go gyro turn, and then let's say I want to turn 45 degrees to the left. So I go 45 degrees and then I set my wheel speed. So left motor is going to be at 0, right motor is going to be at 20. So this should make me do a left turn. Oh, hold on. We also need to reset the angle. Let's try that again. So here we got to make sure we reset our yaw angle. And then make sure our motors are connected, C and D. Yep. Okay, let's try that now. Cool. So that was a 45 degree turn to the left. What if I want to do a turn to the right? Well, it's very simple. So all I have to do is make it so that my left motor is moving faster than my right motor. So my right motor is actually going to do a negative 20. Okay. So let's have a look at this. Cool. So this this has shown how we use some math functions to make our turning code even more reliable and more robust. If you want to check out more about maths and Python, then make sure you check out w3schools.org and then search for Python. And then if you scroll down the side menu, you'll see Python Math. So go into Python Math, and then you'll see all the different kinds of math functions you can use. And then down towards the end, you will actually get a math module reference that gives you all the different kinds of mathematical functions that you can use for your code to make your robot do really awesome things. Okay? I hope you enjoyed this lesson, and I will see you on the next one. Bye-bye.